Big changes are coming to Top 5 Solo Games. Testing a new logo. Thanks a lot for listening. Talk later. Okay, but seriously. There are going to be two big changes coming to the channel. One, I've signed up for a patronage system. And two, I plan on making solo RPG videos. So discussion of the patronage system is shorter, so I will get that out of the way first for people who aren't interested in solo RPGs. I have been having trouble signing up with the payment processing service Stripe for months now. But it is finally settled. For some reason, they thought I was trying to do crowdfunding, which they don't allow. That prevented me from using a patronage system, since every single one of them uses Stripe. But with that cleared up, I started a coffee account. Your Top 5 Solo Games experience won't change at all if you don't subscribe. I appreciate every one of my viewers. So what am I offering you if I am not gating off an existing type of content? Well, you know that I have never, from the start of the channel, wanted to post board game playthroughs and have random people try to learn from them. I can't handle that level of responsibility. But you know that I do board game playthroughs to play in the background of all of my reviews. Well, for months now, I have been narrating all of those playthroughs, and I will provide one exclusive narrated playthrough video every week to my patrons who are forewarned that I play house rules and I make lots of mistakes. So if you want board game playthroughs to watch, if you don't just want to hear me review Primal the Awakening for an hour, but you actually want to hear me suffer through 3 hours of playing through it, click the link in this video's description. It will also continue to be the top link in the channel info. I'm using Ko-fi at the time of filming. And Stripe, if you are listening, I will not be crowdfunding anything. I barely interact with crowdfunding as a consumer anymore. On to topic number two. In the background, you're seeing something that you may find a little bit confusing. And that is a playthrough of a solo RPG. Now, I have a very long history with TTRPGs, but with a huge multi-decade gap in the middle. I started playing Dungeons & Dragons in 1991 with what's known as the Black Box set, which actually allowed for guided solo play, which I only just now realized was my first foray into solo gaming. But I also played with my siblings. Shortly after, I received the D&D Cyclopedia, which I only recently discovered is the complete Beckme version of the game, in which my brother coincidentally happened to find maybe a month or two ago and bring to me. So you can see it doesn't have its cover anymore. It would be very expensive if it did. I didn't so much play through that, though, because my friends that I made in junior high who played Advanced Dungeons & Dragons 2nd Edition, and due to the word advanced, thought it was better. In college, the RPG Club is how I made most of my friends, but I also discovered fiction writing, and as those friends moved away, I didn't try to find a new group. Writing fiction had fulfilled that storytelling need for me, so my last experience with Dungeons & Dragons was 2nd Edition. And we didn't even play that much. We preferred Shadowrun and Palladium games like Rifts and Heroes Unlimited. And yet, I've still been buying games, specifically a lot of PDFs of games. Itch bundles, bundles of holding, drive-through RPG summer sales. I literally have thousands of games. And I had no plan to play them. Now, just as I was struggling through constantly learning new board games, I got the itch to play solo RPGs and record them. So in the future, I will put up playthroughs of solo journal RPGs, but I will also play traditional multiplayer RPGs solo and record those playthroughs and post them. as I've already said, I normally don't post playthroughs, but I'm making up half the rules for this stuff. So, and the fiction is, I think, the draw. The story is the draw. So I'm going to do that. My RPG playthroughs will look different from other people's. I don't find just outlining the events that are occurring interesting. That's what kept me from doing this sooner. I have tried solo RPG with Merc Borg, and it just didn't make enough of a story for me when all I was doing was playing through adventures. If I'm going to do that, I would prefer to just play a fully gamified experience like Four Against Darkness or Dungeon Universalis. And the issue is that, I mean, I do write novels, and I didn't want to start writing fiction out of these. It would be way too slow. I have too much fiction that I need to write to sell. But then I read someone mention that they write scripts. I don't know if they meant it literally, but it struck me how much more quickly I write scripts than fiction, since the description is less detailed, and that's what I kind of struggle with. The description is way more pragmatic in a strip, in a script. So I'm going to make scripts of the game sessions, like movie scripts. That's what you see in the background. And I will speed up the actual writing of it to zip by or cut it out entirely. And then I will read what I create as I go. And we'll just see how this works out. If it's a bigger workload for me, but it's also fun and it's something different that I can offer the solo RPG YouTube community, because I am actually a fiction writer. Also, something that I can offer is that I am not an experienced solo role player. So I am going to be growing and learning on screen. I am already dissatisfied with my first Scarlet Heroes video that you see behind me, but I'm going to post it anyway, instead of trying to re-record it. At the beginning of each session, I will plan to probably describe what I'm going to try doing differently this time, and what tools I'm using, so that you can follow along if you want, and we can learn this crazy world together. I have so many games I want to try. I've done a Wretched and Alone game. It was fun, though not what I expected. I'm doing a Scarlet Heroes with the Labyrinth Lord Bestiary, and using Adventure Crafter and a simple Oracle instead of Mythic, since they make Mythic also makes Adventure Crafter, and it covers so many of the same bases. The game is a story about a gladiator that I had actually considered making a novel, but I'm really, really excited to tell it in game form, which is why I want the structure of the Adventure Crafter lens. I do want to try Mythic. I've got the cards. And I'm using my Game Master Assistant's decks, and I actually ordered a new one to play Cyberpunk. I plan on trying to use some tarot decks, which I bought several cheap ones, some more traditional and some less, which I think will all, though, have different, make for different interesting oracles. I want to use 2d6 Dungeon to generate dungeons and encounters for an OSR game. I want to use Four Against Darkness to do the same. A YouTube channel and creator, Man Alone, said he sees 4AD as a solo boardless board game rather than a solo RPG. But I think it might be as easy to put role-playing into 4AD than to make a traditional RPG soloable. So I'd like to try it on its own as a solo RPG, especially with the newish town supplements. By the way, if you're interested in playing RPG solo, check out the Man Alone Network. He definitely provided a lot of the inspiration for me to finally start down this path, and his channel is insightful and hilarious. I want to play Deep Abandon by Brett Nugent as a grimdark RPG. The characters already have all the stats that you would need to do checks. So it's and it has a method for generating crawls with encounters. It seems perfect. I would do the same thing with Dungeon Universalis, which it practically already is an RPG, but just ignoring the existing plots. because one of the many amazing things about that game is that the levels balance themselves. So you can play them in any order with any level of character and just go off of the difficulty rating of the level. You can also play the dungeons using the online app, revealing one room at a time. And that should be useful and would be fun for you all to see along with Dungeon Universalis, but also with any fantasy TTRPG. It has hundreds of individual scenarios, and I'm guessing that cover basically anything that you could want. And there might even be some actual RPGs that I plan to play beyond all of these board game conversions. My Beckme Dungeon Cyclopedia will, if my story that I'm currently doing, which you're seeing in the background, ends up going to a very high level, I'll probably end up switching over to this from Scarlet Heroes. Scarlet Heroes is an OSR game, and so it'll mesh perfectly with this. You might be familiar with BX Dungeons & Dragons, Basic Expert, but that was only part of its initial plan. In 1983, the background is so complicated. My understanding is the things split. TSR put out like a new Basic and Expert, but then continued with Classic, Master, and Immortal. And I'm promising nothing, but if the story ends up being fun to tell, then this protagonist is going to go from a young gladiator to an immortal. I may play AD&D 2nd Edition, taking it back to my high school days, which I recently found out is pretty much OSR with a little bit of extra stuff bolted on it. Which actually, the majority of the new OSR games, like that kind of is the definition. I printed out a whole thwack of OSR PDFs. You can print them really easily by leaving out the bestiary and spells. So you can see how many this one holds, all in one spine. I'm using the Labyrinth Lord bestiary cards, which are free. And speaking of spells, I usually leave them out because I don't really enjoy playing spellcasters and plan to keep most of my games pretty low fantasy, except that I really want to play a wizard in Dungeon Crawl Classic. It looks absolutely insane. And I want to try Mutant Crawl Classics as well. In fact, I already got all of the crazy dice and printed out, 3D printed a tray for them. These dice are stupid, but should be pretty fun. Savage Worlds looks really amazing. I really love that it's built around miniature play, since I find that a lot of fun, and I definitely plan to use some miniature skirmishing with games that work well with that. For instance, gonna finally bust out that Merc Borg. I've got a very fun idea for how to keep cycling through the scum as they die, and I'm thinking maybe I'll use Forbidden Psalm along with it. Remember that I mentioned I got the new Cyberpunk GMA deck? It's one of the only ones that I didn't have. Well, plan on using it for this, because all you got to do is throw around the right vocabulary, and there you go. You got a cyberpunk game. I also want to try the storytelling-centric approach of Forged in the Dark. It seems like it's easily soloable. They make their own solo rules. I want to try a free league game, and I'm deciding between Forbidden Lands and Dragonbane. I know that it probably sounds like I'm recreating the issue I was having with board games of trying to learn new games constantly. And that could be true, but many of the games that I just mentioned are universal systems that are platforms other games are built upon, letting you easily transition. For instance, OSR, which I already know, and you can find any genre of game that's been done as OSR. Powered by the Apocalypse / Forged in the Dark is another platform game. And so is Savage Worlds, which even lets you play Pathfinder without learning Pathfinder. So if it ever gets stressful, but I'm still enjoying playing, I will start going deep into the systems that I have already learned. I have zero plans to create stress for myself by jumping on the Kickstarter hype train, which seems to be as bad with TTRPGs as with board games. Maybe that will limit how many people find my channel, but I'm okay with that. Actually, I'm very excited to finally put the thousands of PDFs I already own to use. And I even plan to do a video showing you my method of binding them, which it's not exactly the prettiest, but it is the, I mean, it's extremely sturdy. Like, you can fully fold it. You don't have to worry about breaking the glue like with a normal soft cover book. But I don't plan to stop making board game content. First, you know that I've already stated I'm going to try to mix the two. But also, I plan to only solo roleplay when I am alone and can write and record. For me, those artifacts have proven to be necessary to make it a satisfying process. So I am still going to be playing board games in the evenings when my brain won't create words none too good. Takeaways. If you want to watch narrated board game playthroughs, subscribe to my coffee. If you don't, nothing will change. If you want to watch solo RPG videos, stick around. Solo RPG videos will be in addition to my normal board game coverage. Okay, well, I think that's it. I'm really looking forward to this. I hope to have all of you along with me for the ride. And you'll be seeing some of this sort of content very soon. I mean, you're seeing it right. You're seeing it right now, right? Slow down and narrate it. That's it for me. I am J. Allen Reichner, reminding you to keep playing solo.